Here in chapter 7, we're going to be concerned with the chemistry of three dimensions, looking at molecules as they really exist in three dimensions and appreciating some of the aspects of doing that. We've already done a little bit of this back in chapter 3 when we were dealing with Newman projections and chair conformations. We were drawing molecules in a way that allowed us to appreciate their three-dimensional nature. We're going to look at another aspect of that in this chapter. This quote from Alice in Wonderland, that came out at about the same time that the topics in this chapter were beginning to be appreciated. This goes back to the 1850s and 60s. A looking glass is a mirror. So Alice is describing how things look when you see their reflection in a mirror. And as she says, sometimes things go the other way. Molecules have mirror images, and sometimes those images have important characteristics that are different from the molecule itself. And so we're going to be once again seeing some ways of drawing molecules to represent their three-dimensional nature. We've already seen wedges and dashes in structures from chapter 3. We'll get back to that a little bit and talk about some other ways of representing molecules. This next slide kind of puts this in perspective. When we first started talking isomers back in chapter 2, we really were dealing with structural isomers or constitutional isomers, the difference between things like 2-methylhexane and 3-methylhexane, where you have a different connectivity of atoms that led to a difference in their names. Stereoisomers, that's part of what this chapter is dealing with. Stereo means three dimensions, and so far the only kind of stereoisomer we've really seen are the cis-trans isomers. Those are also called geometric isomers. We saw cis-trans when it came to substituted cyclohexane rings back in chapter 3, and it also comes into play in alkenes, carbon-carbon double bond molecules. And in both cases we have to have some way of representing those in three dimensions to kind of keep straight the difference between cis and trans. In this particular chapter, number 7, the kind of stereoisomer we're dealing with is something called optical isomers. Optical refers to interactions with light, and it's how light interacts with these particular isomers that distinguishes them from one another. And as we've already said here, it has to do with mirror images. And in particular, when a molecule's mirror image is not an exact duplicate of the molecule itself. There's some terminology that we'll need for this chapter. Enantiomers, those are molecules that are identical except for the fact that they are non-superimposable on their mirror image. They have the same numbers and kinds of atoms. They're just pointing out in space in different directions. And a common distinction is the situation where you have mirror image molecules that are, again, different in a subtle way. The title of this chapter might also be called A Study in Chirality. That's the next term here. Things that are chiral or have chirality, well, as it says, that means handedness. Your right hand is a non-superimposable mirage of your left hand. If you think about what it looks like when you hold your left hand up to a mirror, what looks back at you is a right hand, and vice versa. So while your hands certainly have a lot in common, they are not perfectly identical. If someone were to switch your left hand, put it on your right arm, and vice versa, you would definitely notice a difference. And so that kind of thing happens in organic chemistry, as it says, especially when you have a carbon atom bonded to four different atoms or four different substituents. That's the setup for chirality, and we're going to be looking at a number of examples of that kind of thing.